Hello friends, I welcome you all in refrigeration and air conditioning lecture. In previous lecture, we have discussed different psychrometric processes. In this lecture, we will see some psychrometric terms that are sensible heat factor, room sensible heat factor, grand sensible heat factor, and effective room sensible heat factor. The question may ask on this topic like that, explain or define sensible heat factor, room sensible heat factor, grand sensible heat factor, and effective room sensible heat factor. So we will see one by one. So first is sensible heat factor. Sensible heat factor, it is defined as sensible heat to total heat. Totally sensible heat divided by total heat means what? Summation of sensible heat plus latent heat. By separating the total heat transfer rate from the cooling coil into sensible and latent heat transfer rate, and the useful parameter called as sensible heat factor. So by using a psychrometric chart, we can calculate sensible heat as well as latent heat. Consider a cooling with dehumidification process. So here is a point one, here is a point number two. In summer condition, the air is at high temperature as well as humidity is also high. The temperature, initial temperature is TD1. These are the outside condition, and room conditions are two. So this is TD2 temperature and W2 is a humidity. So consider this is a point. So sensible heat for this case is, sensible heating is HA minus H2 and latent heat is H1 minus HA. It's a latent heat value. So from this relation we can calculate sensible heat factor. It is nothing but sensible heat upon total heat. Now the next definition or parameter is room sensible heat factor. Now in this case, the room sensible heat factor, we are considering only room heat. So it is defined as room sensible heat divided by room total heat. The heat produced in the room is only considered in room sensible heat factor. So room total heat is nothing but room sensible heat plus room latent heat. Room sensible heat, room sensible heat, and RLH means room latent heat. Okay, so we can show this process on psychrometric chart. Consider again cooling with dehumidification process. Consider this point is R and this is supply condition. Supply condition may change. It is S1 condition, it is S2 condition, S3 condition, like that. So this line represents room sensible heat factor. Now in this case, one important term is ADP. ADP is involved. ADP is nothing but when a cooling and dehumidification process, the temperature at which the room sensible heat factor line intersect the saturation curve. This point is known as ADP. Now consider it is cooling with dehumidification process. When this line is extended up to the saturation curve, this point is known as ADP. This point is known as ADP. Now the main important thing to solve problem or how to draw room sensible heat factor on psychometric chart. Now we have a psychometric chart. So room sensible heat factor scale is given on psychometric chart here. Room sensible heat factor, its value ranges from 1 to 0.20. now we'll see the procedure first, then we will solve one problem on this topic. So the method is important. First, calculate a room sensible heat factor from room sensible heat and room total heat. We can calculate room sensible heat factor. You will get some value 0.8, 0.2 something. Now the first step is step one is mark a point A. Mark a point A on sensible heat factor scale. Now A point is nothing but a room sensible heat factor. Consider this point is A. Here is a psychometric chart. First, calculate a room sensible heat factor value. Consider this point is A. Mark a point A on sensible heat factor scale given on right hand corner of the psychometric chart. Then the step two is join point A and alignment circle reference point. Now alignment circle point, it is given on psychometric chart. So join A and this point B, join A and point B directly. Consider this line is AB, it is a reference line. Then step 3 is mark point R on psychometric chart represents a room design condition. Now the room design condition, consider this R point is room design condition. It is 24 degree Celsius tribal temperature and 50% RH. Okay, relative humidity is 50% and tribal temperature is 24 degree Celsius. So consider this is point is R. This point is considered as R. Then through point R, draw a line parallel to the baseline. From point R, draw a line parallel to AB. So draw the line parallel to AB and give the name, this is R dash point. So through point R, draw a line PR dash parallel to base line AB, parallel to baseline AB. This line is required, or this line is known as room sensible heat factor line. And on this line there is a supply condition. So consider the supply condition may change. You can change the temperature. It is S1, S2, there are n number of supply conditions. The next point is grand sensible heat factor. It is defined as the ratio of total sensible heat to the grand total heat which the cooling coil or the air conditioning apparatus is required to handle. In room sensible heat factor, we are considering only two heats, that are room sensible heat and room total heat. Room total heat is nothing but room sensible heat plus room latent heat. But outside air enter in the room due to the ventilation purpose. So the outside air sensible heat and outside air latent heat is handled by using grand sensible heat factor. So grand sensible heat factor, it is the ratio of total sensible heat divided by grand total heat. Now the total sensible heat divided by grand sensible heat means what? It is the summation of total sensible heat plus total latent heat. But the total sensible heat means what? Total sensible heat is nothing but room sensible heat, the heat available in the room or heat generated in the room, plus outside air sensible heat. And total latent heat is nothing but room latent heat plus outside air latent heat. Now consider V1 is a volume of outside air. Volume of outside air, or you can say that it is ventilation. Ventilation. The value of V, it is in meter cube per minute. Meter cube per minute. Now in this case, the outside air sensible heat calculation and outside air latent heat calculation is important, and by using this V1, the volume of outside air or ventilation air, by using this we can calculate the sensible heat and latent heat. Now the next is how to draw the grand sensible heat factor on a psychrometric chart. So we will see this part. So consider again it is psychrometric chart. Okay, now consider it is the sensible heat factor scale. So first draw the room sensible heat factor. First draw the room sensible heat factor line. So mark first a point. A point we can find out from room sensible heat factor. Now mark a alignment circle point. The point is B. Then join A and B. Then find out a reference point. Then draw a line parallel to AB. Then draw a line parallel to AB. Now the next part is, it is this line represents room sensible heat factor line. Now how to draw the grand sensible heat factor? For grand sensible heat factor, the points are like that. Point number one is consider outside condition. Then point three is mixing condition, and point two is room design condition. So consider point one is outside condition. Outside means surrounding temperatures condition. Three is mixing condition and two is room design condition. So mark point one. Now this R is nothing but room design condition. We can replace this point R by 2. Then join point 1 and 2. It is adiabatic mixing process. So on this line we will get point number 3. Point number 3 represents mixing condition. So one point is outside condition. Then point number 2 is room design condition, and point number 3 is mixing condition. Now consider this point is 4. Point number 4, it is on room sensible heat. It is on room sensible heat factor line. Join 3 and 4 and extend this line up to the saturation curve. Now this 3, 4 line represents grand sensible heat factor line. And the point, intersection point of this grand sensible factor on saturation curve, this prime point represents point number 6, and this point is known as 5 point. Now the 6th point is known as ADP. This line represents grand sensible heat factor line. So this is a line. If you extend this 3 to 4 line up to the saturation curve, this point is known as ADP. Now the next point is calculation of outside air sensible heat. Now the outside air sensible heat we can calculate by using the simple formula 0.02044. V1 is volume of outside air, ventilation air, minus TD1 minus TD2, and outside air latent heat is nothing but 50 V1 is again ventilation air, W1 minus W2, its value is in kilowatt. You will get this heat value, it is in the kilowatt. The next term is effective room sensible heat factor. It is denoted as ERSHF, and effective room sensible heat factor is a ratio of effective room sensible heat to the effective room total heat. Effective room total heat is a summation of effective room sensible heat plus effective room latent heat. Now, effective room sensible heat is nothing but room sensible heat plus outside air sensible heat into bypass factor. This bypass factor, it is for cooling coil or heating coil. And effective room total heat is room latent heat plus outside air latent heat into bypass factor. The effective room sensible heat factor which relates bypass factor apparatus dew point temperature, and by using effective room sensible heat factor we can calculate a capacity of cooling coil or heating coil. So we will see the formulation for effective room sensible heat factor. Now, the outside air sensible heat we can calculate by using a standard formula. This formula is 0.02044 V1 into TD1 minus TD2, and outside air latent heat we can calculate by using this formula 50 V1 W1 minus W2. The unit of this outside air sensible heat and outside air latent heat, it is in kilowatt. Now in this equation, this V1 is ventilation air. When the outside air enter in the room, so the volume of that air is V1. TD1 is a dry bulb temperature surrounding or atmospheric dry bulb temperature, and TD2 is a room dry bulb temperature. Similarly, in this case, V1 is a ventilation air, W1 is a specific humidity surrounding specific humidity, and W2 is a specific humidity. It is known as room specific humidity. So we will see the how to draw effective room sensible heat factor on psychrometric chart. So here is a psychrometric chart. Now consider one point. One point is outside condition. Two point is room condition. Three point is mixing condition. The point number four is supply condition. The air coming from cooling coil or heating coil, it is denoted as point number four. Point number six is ADP. ADP condition. Okay, so first draw a mixing condition. Let us consider point number one and point number two. Point number one is outside condition and point number two is a room condition. When the two condition mix, we will get condition number three. Let us consider this diagram. So it from outside air enter in a mixing chamber. After mixing chamber, there is a cooling coil or heating coil. After cooling coil, the air enter in a room. It is a room, and again the air is enter in a mixing chamber. So some 20 or 30% air is exhausted and 80% is recirculated air. 20% fresh air enter in a mixing chamber. So let's consider this outside condition is 1 and the room condition is 2. Room condition is 2. After mixing chamber we will get condition 3, and after 3 we will get condition number 4. When condition number 4 enter in a room, it handle outside air sensible heat, outside air latent heat, room sensible heat, room latent heat. Now 1 and 2 conditions are mixed in a mixing chamber, then we will get condition number 3. Then the line passing through point to the line, passing through point to is known as room sensible heat factor line. This line is known as room sensible heat factor line. Now the line which passing through point 3 is known as grand sensible heat factor line, and the grand sensible heat factor line intersect room sensible heat factor line. This point is known as point number 4, and the room sensible heat factor line intersection point on saturation curve, it is denoted as 5, and the grand sensible factor intersection point on saturation curve, this point is 6. Point 6 is also known as ADP. It is the coil temperature. Four condition is supply condition. The four condition is supply condition. The low temperature air enter in a room. It handle room sensible heat, room latent heat, outside air sensible heat, and outside air latent heat, and it maintain the room condition. That's are that is 24 degrees Celsius temperature or maybe 50% relative humidity. Now the next important line is effective room sensible heat factor line. Now if you join point number 6 and 2, if you join point number 6 and 2, this line indicates effective room sensible heat factor line. Effective room sensible heat factor line handle room sensible heat, room latent heat, outside air sensible heat, outside air latent heat. Now but in this case we are considering the bypass factor of cooling or heating coil. So the supply condition may change. Now the draw a line passing through point 4, this line parallel to 1 to 2. Draw the line parallel to 1 to 2. So adjust the scale like that and draw a line passing through 4. So this 4 dash, this line is parallel to 1 to 2. Now we will get a new supply condition. That supply condition is known as 4 dash point. We have to modify this 4 point to 4 dash point due to the bypass factor of cooling coil. Now the bypass factor calculation or 4 dash calculation. Now the bypass factor for grand sensible heat factor. Now this line, the line passing through point 3 is known as grand sensible heat factor line. Now you can see that the 4 to 6 is a loss. Then we can write down the TD4 minus TD6 divided by the total distance. It is TD3 minus TD6. So this difference is known as bypass factor. The another bypass factor definition is or formula is TD4 dash minus TD6 divided by TD2 minus TD6. TD6 is apparatus dew point temperature. So you can again modify this formula for bypass factor. It is TD4 minus ADP divided by TD3 minus ADP is equal to TD4 dash minus ADP divided by TD2 minus ADP. We can also show the bypass factor on a psychometric chart. Now consider this 4 point. So this distance is a bypass factor for grand sensible heat factor, and the remaining distance is from point 3. Point 3 is 1 minus bypass factor. It is the efficiency of cooling coil. Similarly, the point 6 remains same. The new modified point for cooling coil is 4 dash. Again, it is a bypass factor for effective room sensible heat factor line, the 0.4 dash and 6 dash distance is known as bypass factor, and the remaining distance from 0.2 to 4 dash point is known as 1 minus bypass factor.